lesbian. Mm. That doesn't mean they were not there. Mm. But African culture believes sex is a private matter. Mm. And a sacred thing for that man. For you to be labeling it in the street and declaring yourself, I'm heterosexual, I'm gay. No, it was your private matter. Mm. Sex is a fraction of life. It's not the sum total of life. So, but because of customary law, see, when customary law goes and say the man is the head of the house and the children belong to the man, what do you think they're doing? They're sexualizing you, but they're also heterosexualizing you, not just sexualizing you. That's why Njinga, that I say go and watch on Netflix, was a polyandrist. There was polyandry now. But polyandry didn't make it into customary law because it affirms women. But polygamy did.
Yeah.
Because polygamy continues.
Yeah.
It's practiced wrong, actually, to dehumanize women. Yeah. It still gives the men power. So LGBTQ is not a new phenomenon, just like gender equity is not. If I have any misgiving with the ANC, is how gender equity was introduced in South Africa.
Yeah.
They introduced this introduced it as part of the United Nations, something of human rights. Yes, Universal Declaration of Human Rights. No, they found us here in gender equity. And then they called it demonic. They said the woman can't lord over you because the Bible says the woman must learn in silence. Women cannot teach men. So they called it demonic and rearranged us. Now they've woken up to development. They are deciding to bring it via the UN.
Yeah.
That's why you see the anger amongst African men. Have you ever thought, had the ANC done the right thing and said, guys, this is how we were pre-colonial. Because we are decolonizing, this is what we are bringing back.
Yeah.
Do you think it would have been more palatable to Africans? Of course.
Yes.
Of course, that's not what they did. They said the UN says.
Yeah.
Now, if I'm African, I say, who the fuck is the UN? The UN doesn't put bread on my table. So I don't care what the UN wants. This is how I've been living because customary law has convinced me for 5 generations now. This is my culture. So what is the UN telling me? So now we are pitting the people against the UN. Meanwhile, this thing has been African all the time. You know, in Africa, in the book that I've written, I've gone through 9 different types of marriages, and because the book is not focused on marriage, I was just tapping the surface. I didn't even go deep. Just tapping the surface. What we call dowry ilobola is practiced the same now because of customary law. It's always from the men to the women. You know, in pre-colonial societies in Africa, you had societies where it was the women who lobolaed the men, the other way around. You had societies where lobola was not paid at all. You had societies in West Africa, Nomsa, where you were allowed to get married, give children, and say, I think I'm tired of this. I leave this man and these kids. I'm going. You were not labeled. You were not called anything. And whatever they did for these kids, they still called you. If you were married with a husband, you come with him to do right by these kids. It was a system of marriage. You had so many different types of systems. They've reduced you to what the Quran and the Bible prescribes because the nucleus family fits capitalism. So even the way LGBTQ has been reintroduced, it's not introduced as something that existed before. It's introduced as what the UN demands. You understand? So then there's a dichotomy. There's this tussling and fighting back against the system. It wasn't important for us to label it. I mean, we had what we called the village wife. I'm sorry. But if we live pre-colonially, I think I would have been a village wife. I hate to work. I really hate to work. I want someone to plow for me, to do this. It's different from how you guys are doing it.
Yeah,
it's different from, because, no, that's different. Because slay queens are handbags.
Yeah,
and they are even abused physically. Now, the village wife was respected. That was your role. You decided, I don't want to belong to anybody, so I work. So whoever comes here, you come for labor first, then we can have sex. They call them the village wife. We had different types of these things. Christianity reduced you to only 2, heterosexual, and in heterosexuality, polygamy. Ask yourself why the 2, because the man is still on top in both of them. So I don't know if Boko, we are satisfied I say I was born like this. That's the dilemma when you introduce something from the top and you don't ground it in history.
And incest.
Yes.
It can be abused and even sleeping with kids. What is it called, by the way?
Pedophilia.
Because there are people who are arguing this is how I am.
Yeah.
So it does have its abuses. That is not to take away from the genuinity of the people whose sexual orientation is this.
Thank you.